novels up in Alaska and up in the north, this novel was a little different and spoke to me in a really unique way. It was about a couple, a young couple in the turn of the 19th or 20th century, and they felt betrayed by the industrialized nature of things happening in the cities, and that everything that their ancestors wanted for them by moving west and moving to America was a lie, and that they needed to find their own way and their own spirit. And so they went and they reconnected with nature and they went back to the land. And I read that at a time when I was considering leaving the city and moving to the woods. And yeah, best thing I ever did. And while I was reading this book, I was driving up in the Northern California and I got lost. I was looking for a dog. I'm shopping for a dog. And we're looking for a breeder, and I got completely lost on the highway. And I had just finished this novel days before and was really thinking a lot about it. And it turns out where I ended up pulling over was Jack London's grave. And his home site, so it was just kind of a big connection. The vultures are flying lower than they used to. They don't waste their time on old bleached bones. Feel choked out. Our past betrayed by spoken mirrors. All she gives is a stone facade, like ill-given flowers at a dead man. Wake. Here we slave for the dreams of another and fight over scraps like wayward dogs. The ash under ignite our souls.
Words ignite our souls.